Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa and today I'm making ganache. Penicillin, microwave oven, sticky labels known as post-its, potato chips, ganache. What in the name of sweetness all of these inventions have in common? They were made by mistake, that's what. So, ganache. Today it is a well-known and well-loved word because it means yumminess in loose translation. Wikipedia is, as always, very formal and precise. So you will find this definition. Ganache is a glaze, icing, sauce or filling for pastries made from chocolate and cream. However, some 100 years ago in France, that word was used as a serious insult to describe a person of low intelligence, to say that politely. So, what's the deal? According to culinary folklore, the word was coined in the 1920s by the famous French chef Georges Auguste Escoffier. The story goes that one day his clumsy apprentice accidentally poured hot cream into a bowl of chocolate pieces, and the chef, in a Gordon Ramsay style, shouted at him, "Ganache!" However, that undesired accidental invention became extremely popular and adored in the sweetness universe because it tastes heavenly. It can be used for making truffles, as cream in cakes and pastries, as a sauce or as a glaze. Its texture depends on the chocolate to cream ratio. When there is more cream than chocolate, the ganache will be lighter and also liquid at room temperature. If, however, ganache contains more chocolate than cream, then it will be firmer, becoming solid at room temperature. Ganache as cream or filling in cakes and pastries is a bit softer than ganache for making truffles. The most commonly used ratio of ingredients is the same amount of chocolate and cream by weight. That type of ganache is very liquid until it cools down at room temperature, when it becomes soft and creamy. If you put it in the refrigerator, it will become firm. Ganache sauce, in my mind, would be a thick chocolate mass where I can dip my churros, cookies, why not, or anything sweet and crispy, or it can be drizzled over a bowl of ice cream. Everything tastes better with some chocolate ganache sauce, doesn't it? For this purpose, I would put some more cream than chocolate by weight into the ganache. Ganache glaze is a beautiful and shiny outer coating of a cake or pastry. When making the ganache for the glaze, it should be liquid once made, and you should use it immediately while it is still warm. So you see, in the sweetness universe, and only here, it takes only two elements, chocolate and cream, and a lot of imagination to create magic. So let's make some. Ganache, here we come. As usual, the recipe is on my site, the link is down below. To make dark chocolate ganache with 1:1 chocolate to cream ratio, I'm gonna pour hot cream over my chocolate. I'll leave it for 1 minute to allow the cream to melt the chocolate. Then I'm gonna stir until incorporated. After that, I will add softened butter and stir until it melts, like I did in my chocolate ganache tart recipe. The link is down below. To make milk chocolate ganache with 2:1 chocolate to cream ratio, I've melted my chocolate on low heat in the microwave and I've heated the cream until lukewarm. I'm gonna pour the cream into the chocolate gradually and stir thoroughly after each addition. After that, I'll add softened butter and stir until it melts. If I want to use ganache as a glaze, I'll pour it over my cake as soon as it is done, like I did in my marble chiffon cake recipe. The link is down below. If I want to use my ganache as a filling, I will leave it on the counter until it becomes pipeable, and then I will pipe it like I did in my d'acquoise recipe. The link is down below. You can give your ganache a different character by flavoring it with herbs, spices, or orange, lemon, or lime zest. So now we'll see a clip from my white chocolate and lemon truffles video, the link is down below, where you will see how to make lemon-flavored white chocolate ganache. If you want to make plain white chocolate ganache, omit lemon zest and lemon juice. Don't forget to replace the lemon juice with the same quantity of cream. To make lemon-flavored white chocolate ganache, first I will grate lemon zest into my cream. Then I can leave it overnight in the fridge or heat the mixture and leave it for 15 to 30 minutes on the counter to infuse. I've melted white chocolate in the microwave and now I'll strain warm lemon-infused cream into the chocolate and add lemon juice. I will stir with a whisk until the mixture becomes uniform. Then I will add softened butter and stir until ganache becomes nice and shiny. There, you have become the ganache expert, so roll up your sleeves and start melting that chocolate. Long live ganache!
Oh baby, you are so sweet, so delicious and yummy. So good to eat. I wanna lick you. Feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you wanna stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And of course, visit my site, where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information, and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site, you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!